You know, you write about adolescence a good deal. Most people are running from this awkward time, but you delve right into Oscar's most awkward and painful experiences in his coming of age story. What do we get from revisiting this time in our lives?
Well, you know, I mean, think about it. There's that saying, the child is the father of the man. And I always think that in our adolescence, we give birth to our adult selves. And it's also in adolescence when the society teaches us about itself. I mean, almost always at that time is when we learn about beauty standards, about social standards, about how violently hierarchical our society is, who's in, who's out, who's popular, who's not, and how we react to all these darn pressures, all this craziness. At the same time, we're coming into like contact with changes in ourselves. Nothing reveals the human heart quite like all those shifts. And I find that time, that tumultuous, trying, often instructive period, remarkable material for art, remarkable material for the view of what is human. Yeah.
And the book is as much about Oscar and his experience growing up as it is about some of the brutal history in the Dominican Republic under the dictator Trujillo. And so tell us why you decided to make it almost two equal parts and to focus so much on this character's past, his ancestry.
Yeah, I mean, if you think about it, if you're like a kid in New Jersey who, you know, is just growing up the way Oscar grows up, you know, in some ways incredibly typical, there's no sense that a kid from New Jersey is connected in any way to the larger history of the country, to the larger history of the hemisphere, to the larger history of the planet. And part of it is that this is an argument about how connected we are to all this stuff that we don't think about or we don't even consider part of our heritage. I mean, Oscar just wants to read science fiction novels and wants to get a date. But Oscar's connected not only to American history, not only to American history in the New World, not only to Caribbean history, not only to this terrifying dictatorship in the Dominican Republic, but he's connected to the deepest global history of how we were made, how we became the world we are through enslavement, through extermination, through capitalism. And I know it sounds kind of nutty to make those connections, but that's what I was trying to do in the book, is to remind us that we all, in some ways, belong and are connected to these larger flows. And I thought it was a great way to do it, to remind someone that this anonymous sort of, you know, everyday schlub is in fact the child of these larger historical forces. And by extension, we all are.